What's up guys, it's SilverResidence Game here, back with another video, and today I'm doing a new video. What you see behind me is some gameplay of me playing Black Ops 2, which my third time. Oh my god, stop texting people. It's my friends, I'll try to mute them. But I don't know what they're talking about. But today I will be uploading a new type of video. It's gonna be like a story time. Now I've seen a whole bunch of don't leave mute 1 hour. Okay. So it's gonna be a story time type of video. What I was talking about before I got really interrupted by my friends. I don't have any friends. I was talking about the story time. Now I've seen these on YouTube like a lot. And there's channels even dedicated to story times. Like Leafy is here. He's pretty cool. You should check him out. Some of his stories are really funny. Actually, no, all of them are funny. But yeah. Now before this video starts, I want to get this out of the way. You guys should really subscribe to my two friends, Sora's. That's me. You guys should really subscribe to my two friends, John David Plays and Left 4 Goats Game. Left 4 Goats Game and John David Plays, they've been on my episodes before, and now they decided to make a channel. So yeah, just telling you, I'm not being sponsored by them. Why would I be sponsored by my friends that I don't have? But all jokes aside, let's get into the story. So when I was in 4th grade, I loved it there. I've been in like this private school from 2nd grade to 4th grade, and then into the summer of after 4th grade, my mom told me that I was moving schools, and I was just, like, crying and tears. I was, like, I could have made, like, a freaking flood if I wanted to, but I was so sad. I was like, oh, I can make my own decisions. She was like, well, that happens when you're older. I was crying and crying, and then summer passed. And I was at this new school, and I hated it there. On the first day of school, I remember thinking, so I was one of the first people there in the classroom, and I was like, fifth grade. So after everybody gets there, the teacher introduces himself. He says, oh, my name is Mr. Blah Blah. I like blah blah blah. And he told us introduce ourselves. So everybody went around telling what their name is, telling what they like to do. You know, it was going all smoothly and stuff. I was just like waiting for my turn. And this kid stands up, and let's just give him Thomas the name, because I don't want to say his real name. I'm sorry, Thomas, if you're watching this, but your sacrifice is for the greater good. But, so Thomas stands up, and he's like, oh, I like Minecraft and all this other stuff. And he said, I don't remember what he said, but I remember he said, I like Minecraft. And at that time, I thought Minecraft was super nerdy. It was crappy. It just stunk. And I was like, oh, I'm never going to be friends with this kid. And, like, I used to be really defiant when I was little. So every recess, I would just sit on the bench, and just put my head down, act like I'm super sad, and just not play in the playground or anything. And so, like, a couple weeks later, I was on the basketball court just looking at people shoot hoops. And I don't know why I was looking at people doing that. But, this kid walks up to me, Thomas walks up to me, and I was like, oh god, it's Thomas. But then he starts talking about Minecraft, and I remember the first thing he said was, hey, do you know what slimes are? And stuff like that, and I was like, no. He's like, oh, they're from Minecraft, and we were talking about zombies and stuff. And then he was the one that actually introduced me to Minecraft Pocket Edition. He was talking about it, and I was like, what's that? He's like, oh, it's so awesome, you should buy it. And he's talking about all this stuff, but, so he seemed pretty normal to me, but a couple weeks passed by, and he started talking very weirdly. Like, we were friends by then, but he was like, So one secret he told me, he liked practically every girl in fifth grade except for one girl. No, take that back. He liked every girl in fifth grade except for three girls. And one of them was ugly. One of them he hated for some reason. I think it was because she's from Spain, but she was pretty cool. And she hated me because I was friends with him. And another girl just hated everybody for some reason except for girls. So, yeah. And the girl that hated everybody except for girls, I found out something about her and I told Thomas and he told everything, but that's for another video. So after being friends for a couple of weeks, I started noticing that he was doing weird things, like extraordinary things, not extraordinary, not like E.T. or John C. I noticed that he would start telling me these weird secrets, and one of them was every night he would pretend it's a different girl, and he would wait till his parents fall asleep, and after that, he would hump the teddy bear and then go to sleep for some reason. I don't know, he was weird. But he showed me a picture of his teddy bear, but not while, like a video of when he was doing it, or like when I was over his house. He didn't show me how he does it. That would be even too weird for me to comprehend. And I thought that it was just one thing, but week by week, he would tell me weirder stuff or do weird things in front of me. So there's this jungle gym, and then there's this tower with a telescope at the top, and we would fight the girls, you know, thug life, beat them up, kick them, spit them, and then go on top. Please, well, the only thing you can't say was came out to play. Stay out my way, mother. First we gonna rock, then we gonna roll, then we let it pop, don't let it go. What? X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna roll, then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. He never gave nothing to me. And King of the Playground, no, we didn't do that, but we would race the girls up, and we would always win, and so when we were at the top, I was like, so what do you want to do? And then the girls just walked away, and they're walking on the field, because we beat them on the top, to the top of the crane tower thing, and I was like, so what do you want to do? And he was like, I was like, what are you doing? He was like, oh, I'm just looking at their butts. So I was like, don't you want to look at the clouds? Something else. I was trying to, like, make him do something else that wasn't as weird. He's like, no, I'm good. I was like, okay. We need to find ourselves another friend here. Just kidding. But he would do a whole bunch of other things. Now, one time he actually asked me if he should ask out the English teacher. And she already had a fiancé. No, that's not the big problem here. Her husband, fiance, was a really cool dude. He's really chill, really nice, funny. But the big problem was that he wanted to ask out a 25-year-old English teacher, and he was 11. And he was asking me if he should do it. And I was like, are you serious? And he's like, yeah. I was like, no. One other thing I can remember about fifth grade that he told me, he wanted me to bring like a beatbox or something, boombox to school on the last day of school, so he could download a song on my iPod, so he could sing to a girl and ask her out. And she was in my grade, and she was one of the girls that hated him. And for some reason, I was like, okay. And lo and behold, we did not do that on the last day of school. The last day of school, all we did was go home. And yeah, that's pretty yeah, we just both went our separate ways. And he didn't come to middle school with me. He moved. And yeah, that's the last I heard. Actually, no. We keep in contact sometimes on Skype. But I don't really talk to him that much, because he's a creeper, kind of. And yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you want to hear more about Thomas, don't forget to leave a like, and comment down below, and subscribe
if you want to keep your soul.
Guys, are you gonna fix that? Fix my demon translator right now, okay?
Okay.
Oh yeah, can you also cut that out for me? I don't want them to know I'm a demon, okay? Yeah. Okay, thanks. Okay, guys, I hope you have a wonderful weekend, or whenever I'm posting this, I hope you have a wonderful day. And this is
Soul Resonance.
Hey, I thought you said you'd fix it. I'm gonna kill you. Oh god, we're still recording. This is, how do you turn this thing off? How do you do it? Okay, I think I have it off.
Invincible.